Welcome back to Mr. Bob's Builds. In today's episode, I review and build this model. It's Tamiya's 1/48 scale BA-64B Russian Armoured Car. I don't want to spoil the ending for you, but I loved every minute of this build. While grappling with the complexities of the Flower Class Corvette and dealing with the oh-so-intricate photo etch, and during completion of the form, I fancied some simple glue-on styrene action. And after seeing a very good review of this kit, I decided to splash my £13 and dive right in. And I have to say, I've got my money's worth out of this kit. And I'm going to tell you why. The box is pretty standard for Tamiya's 1/48 military vehicles output. Stout top opening box. A decent image of the prototype surrounded by a striking black border. It would appear that the vehicle in the box art has been based on the one in this photograph, which I think was taken in Vienna in 1945. It certainly has the same vehicle number, 249, and the same recognition paint scheme in the form of the white fenders and the white stripe on the front of the vehicle. We'll return to that particular vehicle later in the review. The single sprue you see in front of you is it. No more. But what a sprue it is. 100% free of flash, very little by way of moulding lines, and cunningly placed sprue attachments. It includes a very nice figure, a useful set of separate pioneer tools. These may be a bit chunky in terms of scale, but they look the part on the model. There is also a decal sheet containing the two numbers, and again, that's it. So you don't get a lot of plastic for your £13, but what you do get is top quality. You also get the fold-down instruction sheet, which is typical with Tamiya's smaller kits. And these are easy to follow. The build is broken down into six short steps. And here the chassis comes together, followed by the four road wheels, and then the main body parts. The tool you see next to the body of the model is Deluxe Materials glue applicator. This allows for pinpoint accurate placement of liquid glues. My daughter, bless her, bought me this for Christmas, and I used it for the first time on this model, coupled with their Plastic Magic liquid glue. I have to say that this is the first time that I've made a model and not left a gluey fingerprint on it. I'm going to be using this applicator for all my models from now on. The company FlexEye File also do a glue applicator, which looks exactly the same. You can see a review of that particular model on the ISM news show for February, where Paul does a very good review of it. The fenders are on. I decided to paint most of the small parts on the sprue. And here all the sub-assemblies are ready for painting. The figure's been put together too, and it's had my usual black and white undercoating. And we're ready for paint. I don't have ready-mixed Russian tank colours on my paint shelf, so I base-coated with Tamiya XF65 Fill Grey. It was progressively lightened with XF71 IJN Cockpit Green and Flat White. It might not be 100% historically correct, but it looks pretty good to me. I used an airbrush to place the different tints. To start the weathering process, I also used the airbrush to put some streaking effects on the main body and sprayed some light dust colours on the bottom half of the vehicle, as well as on the wheels and the chassis. Looking on the web, I found another illustration of vehicle number 249. Again, placing it in Vienna in 1945. This illustration shows unit numbers as well as the vehicle number. Tamiya only provide the vehicle number 249, so I decided to paint the unit numbers And that went well, so I painted the vehicle number as well. As Cohen said, decals? We don't need no stinking decals. Then it was the turn of the figure, and that got finished too. It's a super little figure. I added a bit of photo etch chain to the tow bar. This was left over 1/350th anchor chain from the HMS Anchusa build. And I added a bit of lead wire to the front headlamp. Other than that, it was a straightforward out-of-the-box build. Overall, it was a thoroughly enjoyable build. Well designed, quick to make, and a joy to paint. If you're looking for a weekend build, want to restore your mojo, or just want some fun putting some plastic together, I thoroughly recommend this kit. Before I leave you with some shots of the finished model, I thought I'd quickly look forward to what's coming next on Mr. Bob's Builds. International Scale Modeler Forum has just started a collective build entitled Still Rain, which is basically a towed and motorised artillery group build, or special interest group. I'm going to take part in that and build an 18-pounder field gun, a British gun from the First World War, and set it in a diorama with a crew and other figures. My current thinking is to base this in August or September 1914, in the very first days of the war. This is quite a small model. It's a 4mm scale, or 176, and the gun and crew are made of white metal. I aim to do a series of videos showing the build in progress and talking about some of the processes I'm going to follow. So I hope you'll pop along from time to time to see how things are going. So it's goodbye for now. Thank you for watching, and come back soon. I'm now going to leave you with some photographs of the finished BA-64B Russian Armoured Car.